I designed this partial case for one of my previous electronics projects without taking any measurements from the actual PCB, yet the holes and other dimensions match perfectly. In this video I will show the methods I use to achieve this, so you can create cases around your projects. If you don't have a 3D printer and want to get your own models printed, you can use 3D printing service provided by this video's sponsor PCBWay.com. In addition to PCBs that start from $5 for 10 pieces of 10x10cm PCBs, they offer many other services as well. One of them is 3D printing using many different materials. Material options include, for example, many different types of resin and nylon, PLA, PETG, and something that most of us can't print with our own printers. Metals like aluminum, stainless steel, and titanium. You can upload your CAD file, fill in your preferred options, and submit it to request a quote. You will get some kind of estimated quote automatically, but once PCBWay's staff has checked the request, they will update the final price. For PCB, 3D printing, and CNC milling projects, check out PCBWay.com's offering on their website. So I designed my electronics projects using KiCad. In KiCad there's 3D viewer, which can be used to check how the assembled PCB would look like. That's not the only thing that components 3D models are used for. We can export the model of the assembled PCB as step file by selecting File, Export, Step. In the window that opens, make sure to check Substitute similarly named models to include components models from their step files in the exported step file. My choice for 3D CAD software is Fusion 360. I'll open the step file in Fusion and the PCB and all the parts are now their own components in the Fusion project. First thing to do, before anything else, is to enable capturing design history. This allows editing previous steps in the timeline, but the steps that are done before capturing has started cannot be edited without undoing everything that has been done after that step. Next thing I always do is creating a new component. Right click the top level element and select new component. I give it the name board and drag all the components imported from the step file inside that component. Next I will create another component and name it case. All the sketches and models I'll create will be created inside this case component. To start modeling the case, I will create a sketch in the same plane as the PCB. Then I'll project the PCB's outline to that sketch. I need to create 3 offset copies of the outline. One is just couple tenths of the millimeter larger than the PCB. This is the inside of the case. Second offset is the same offset plus desired wall thickness. This is the outside of the case. And the third offset copy is millimeter or 2 smaller than the PCB. That will be used to create this ridge or lip where the PCB can rest against on. Next becomes the first extrusion. I will extrude the area between 2 outer offset copies. Start will be from the object and I select the bottom of the PCB. Extend type will be the object and I select the tallest object, which is top of this DC jack. I will also add little bit offset to extrude slightly higher, in case that the jack isn't soldered perfectly flat against the PCB. Then I'll extrude everything in that sketch, creating a top for this case. Starting from the top surface of the previous extrusion and going up by desired wall thickness. Now before punching holes for connectors, buttons, etc., I will create that feature that PCB will rest against. Currently the walls extend to the bottom surface of the PCB, but there's nothing preventing PCB going deeper inside that case. I'll extrude the areas between offset copy that is smaller than the PCB and the inner edge of the case. This time start position will be the top surface of the PCB and I will extrude it all the way to the top of the case, making wall thicker above the PCB. The basic shape of the partial case is there and it's time to create the required holes. For each surface that has holes, I will create a new sketch on that surface and then project relevant shapes from the PCB component. For the parts that go through the hole, I will project the part outline and then add little bit of offset to not make that hole too tight. Other holes are sketched mainly around the center points of the adjustment screws, tacked switch patterns, etc. The shape and size for those holes depend on specific use, mainly specified by external factors like screwdriver size or cable diameter. Once these steps are done, the case model is like the one I had printed. Fits nicely around the assembled board, hole positions match the components on the board. This specific case isn't really useful, but it was demonstration of basic steps I take while creating a case in Fusion 360 for my KiCad projects. I hope this was helpful. See you in next video. Thanks.